So note to self, don't be in the Blair Witch Project in 1997. Good to know.
Not
Oh, hi! Hey, everybody. Welcome to Critic Box, you fellow criticers, where we just chat and talk and gossip about Hollywood and actors and movies and what residuals they didn't get from the Blair Witch Project because they made the movie for $700 and yeah, nobody got paid. And then apparently nobody got paid after that.
That's the part.
You know, I am joined by the wonderful Silk of Cinema, Andrea. Andrea, how are you doing today?
I'm good. And actually considering tattooing that nickname on my arm, like on my forearm. What's your name?
You get that, just like pop that up, like
exactly.
We're joined by, and you're like,
Silk of Cinema.
Andrea.
Yeah.
You get Silk of Cinema and then follow it up with Andrea.
Exactly.
Okay, so today, what do we have today? We got some mystery trailers to watch.
Oh.
And you know how much we love some mystery trailers.
Right, because they just fall into our laps.
Yeah, because I don't look up trailers. The producers do it for us. And oh my God, what is this? Kill This Journey is one. Oh my God, yes.
L-O-C-O.
This looks like a fun slasher movie. Let's watch it.
Oh my gosh.
Oh. 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 What is this? Is this Indian Kill Bill?
Happy 4th anniversary.
Hold on. Indian, let's hold a Kill Bill.
Yes.
Yes!
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh! Not sure what happened, but looks intense.
Oh, oh my.
Oh, dang. Oh, yes. Oh, damn, in the trailer.
Oh, he was upset, I think.
Oh, he is not happy.
जिस हिसाब से फाइट चलाता है ना साला चाचा ये साधारण फौजी नहीं है
वो
लोग कुछ भी कर सकते हैं गजब विस्फोटक प्यार है बे फौजी का
ऐसे कौन मारता है बे? रक्षक नहीं हो तुम? जरा राक्षस हो तुम राक्षस।
बाकी तो
Okay.
I am riveted.
Wow.
I am
getting Old Boy vibes. I am getting The Raid vibes. Like, I'm getting one man starting in the back of the train and whooping ass all the way to the conductor's room.
Jason Stratham, freaking Keanu Reeves.
Oh, yeah.
This is all of that. This is Bruce Willis. This is Die Hard. It's all of that.
John Wick.
Fun. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like,
what? You took the wrong girl on the wrong train.
I don't know what it is about that.
Just,
of violence. But when they do it well.
When you are just whooping bad guys' ass, and not like, you know, kind of bad guy, I can see their side kind of bad guy. I mean, objectively, screw these guys. Don't care about any single one of them. None of them are redeemable. Just go ahead and whoop ass. Make your way from back to front.
It's absolutely cathartic.
It is.
And if these are like horrible villainous creatures that you act like the audience would want to actually see hurt, maimed, and
screw these thieves or thugs or whatever.
right, unspeakable things done to them, then you're just like, yeah, I am into it. And that part of it alone, yes. Because every once in a while, we just all need to crash out into some real gory violence and just live there. We can't do it. No one's going to catch a case for this in real life. No. But on a movie screen.
I wouldn't get through one guy, let alone like 17. I mean, this is it's simple premise. Like, literally, it was like Bowser stole the princess. Now Mario's pissed. And then he's just level by level going to be making his way whooping ass to get up to him. I don't need a complex storyline. Not every time. Sometimes, you know, like, hey, if you can deliver me some beautiful, stunning visuals, that's it.
Right. But see, that's the thing about Indian filmmakers. And yeah. I'm going to use Monkey Man as the example because Monkey Man actually had a Western world release, North American release. It's just that there's going to be that, you know, there's going to be the whole especially in Indian action flicks. There's going to be I'm slapping you upside your head. I'm kicking you in your ass. I'm breaking your arm. You're just going to have to take it. Yep. But I think what Indian filmmakers do well is that they hide the story. They hide the moral of the story. They hide the character arcs behind all of that. And I'm not familiar with this filmmaker or the writer of this film. Mm-hmm. But if Monkey Man is anything to say about what the quality of Indian filmmaking is all about, there's going to be a story there. And it's probably going to be something that people can relate to and resonate with. But it's obviously the violence that's the sell. It's obviously the violence that's drawing people in. And people are going to want to see that. But I'm kind of curious about the writing behind it, if there's going to be that story.
And
what the story is, because it's obviously about a love and a man and his wife. But
oh, yeah. Simple, like, you took girl, I get girl back. You know, yeah. I make you pay for taking girl. Yeah. Simple. Like, what I'm hoping for is, and I call this the Bruce Lee technique of I am going to indiscriminately either kill you or knock you out. I'll decide on my way. Where it's like, you just see, like, I'm gonna break your arm and knock you out, and this other guy, I'm gonna take a knife and put it into your eye and you're dead, and then I'm gonna go over there and just take a fire extinguisher and just give you a concussion, and this other guy, I'm gonna cave your face in. And you're just like, why did he get to die and he didn't? Like, it's just as he feels. As he goes, like, he just looked like you need a knife in your face. And this guy looking like, well, he gets to go home. This other guy's dead. You know, where it's like, what, like, as you're fighting and making your way through there, like, how are you deciding who lives and dies here?
It was like a stunt coordinator wasn't even involved.
The stunt coordinator was like, I'm not the writer. But I just make things pretty.
But you see, that's the credit to this filmmaking, because it looks like that. It looks like this guy randomly was just like, I now have a cop. I was cool. I was chill. Me and my girl, we were going somewhere. Now I have a cause, and that cause is driving me to cause you all unimaginable pain or even sometimes death.
That's I didn't ask for this today. You made this happen for me today. Now I'm going to make this happen for you.
Y'all started this shit. That's exactly
I didn't start this. Look, I was just going to take this train trip and we're just going to enjoy a day at the beach. And I just proposed to my girlfriend. It was great. It was a great day. You ruined my day. I'm going to ruin your day. Jim dies. Greg, you get to go home with a broken arm. And that's just how it's going to be.
It's like, none of this had to happen. Y'all started this, so I'm going to make sure I finish it. And if I finish it, you're going to remember how I finished it. Okay?
Like Rambo, I didn't start this war. You did.
Okay. That's the beauty of this movie. It's like, for that premise alone, I will see this. I will watch this. I really hope that it has an English dub. Because reading subtitles while you're trying to watch the action and see how the fight was stunt, was choreographed, that's difficult. And it's difficult.
I would beg to differ, because sometimes what's difficult is when they dub and it's just flat and you don't hear any of the natural acoustics or sound effects. I don't like dubbing just because they just flat over everything. And like, that's why I like the subtitles, because you have the original audio. The original audio is what gets me. I don't like it when they cut out the entire audio and put their own, and then they're just crappy sound effects. We're like,
I know.
You know, and it doesn't sound right at all, you know? And so
sometimes the dubbing qualities of some of these foreign films.
It can be done right, and I've heard it done right, but it's yeah.
Yeah, no, it has been done right. And there's companies out there that actually specialize in this. And there's great voice actors that can actually catch the tone and the intonation.
The emotion.
What these foreign actors are trying to convey. So I really hope that, you know, if money looks like it was spent in that, okay?
Oh, yeah.
Same.
Some good money was spent on there. I mean, that dude's head on fire looked kind of funny.
Just a little bit.
But you know what? Everything else looked really good.
Right. But so I'm saying, if you're going to do all that to make it look so good, I mean, especially if you want an English release, please just make it sound good. So people like me who have no idea about the Indian language and...
Or the 54 dialects that they have. Yeah,
exactly. So that a person like me can understand the actual dialogue. In addition to watching great amounts of violence, that looks really, really cool.
I'm excited about it. What is it? Kill coming out July 5th, 2024. Catch it.